Visit Lowe's and take on the Pro Brand Challenge with the new Flex Stacked Lithium Battery. More power, longer battery life, and faster charging. Plus, it's compatible with all Flex 24-volt power tools. Right now, the more Flex 24-volt tools you buy, the more you'll save. Get up to $150 off today. Stop by or visit us online and see Flex. Exclusively at Lowe's. Valid 519 through 76. Savings vary based on purchase amount. Exclusive versus National Home Centers for Flex 24-volt. U.S. only.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by Chev.
What's up? It's your boy, the Ted Smith. Thanks for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast. Want more? Check out the greatest podcast in all the land, The Podcast. Be sure to subscribe and listen to a brand new episode every Tuesday night.
Somebody out there deserves to be recognized. And the Men's Room knows just who it is. So to you, we say, bottoms up, sailor. You're the toast of our shot of the day.
Three time it is, as usual, we head to the drink desk and Steve and Thrill Hill to find out who we're toasting.
Yes, indeed. And today, actually, man, like I'm a bit of a nerd. So today we toast a Belgian-born scientist and mathematician that academia nerds around the world deeply respect. The thing is, he died on Sunday at the age of 91, but he left behind a legacy of research in group theory, if you know anything about that, as well as geometry. Plus, he won the Abel Prize in 2008. That's an annual award given by the King of Norway that recognizes pioneering sacrifices, scientific achievement in mathematics. Anyway, he leaves behind a heritage of critical higher learning, and his name is Jacques Tits.
Jacques, that's a weird name.
That is the man's name. And he's 91 years old. And one of the things they point out about Jacques Tits there is everything he did. He was so well respected in his field that he got some theories named after him, and he insisted that the theories carry his last name. He doesn't even know Jacques. He has several buildings named after him, right?
Wow.
Like our guy Harry Balls in Indiana did not get the Harry Balls Center. Well, Jacques Tits, he's got buildings. He has a research group. He has a research center. So do yourself a favor. That is Jacques Tits. Look him up. The guy.
Legend.
Legendary mathematician, but now a legend to me just for name alone.
Mm. Well, thank you for keeping us abreast of his passing.
Absolutely. So we pour this booze. And we drink this booze because we think it's yummy.
Yummy!
So over the tongue and down the throat to party in our tummies.
Down the hola, bejola!
The Men's Room presents Profile This.
Hey, Stephen Throw Hill, could you please tell everyone how Profile This is played?
I sure can, Miles. It's a simple game where we share with you a real-life news story. Something here. Something that happened right here on planet Earth. And as you listen to the story, based on the stereotypes you believe to be true of people and the decisions that people make, we'll ask you what it is you think makes the story a story. Hello, Josh. Welcome to the Men's Room.
Hola.
Hola. All right, Josh, you understand how this here game is played?
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, then you know you have your choice of one of three stories. We have The Wonderful World of Drugs. We have Bite Me. In other words, what did someone find in their food? And finally, interior decorating, where you guys see foreign object that ended up on the inside of someone.
Let's do drugs.
Josh, the way you sounded there, I don't know if that's the story you want or if you just want to hang out and do drugs. But since we're not physically together, let's go with the story. We go to Kennewick, Washington. We keep it local, where police say Alexander Richard Yell, he was stealing Pokemon cards from Walmart when he got into a shootout with an armed security guard. Again, you get into a shootout because you're stealing Pokemon cards. Anyway, he tried to steal the Pokemon cards, but while escaping from Walmart, he pushed an employee to get away. A loss prevention officer tried to follow Yell through the parking lot. He did record his license plate information, but while following him, Yell showed up and confronted the security guard and pulled out a gun. He fired one round at the security guard before the security guard grabbed his gun and fired several rounds back at Yell. Yell, by the way, was shot twice before leaving the area in a vehicle. Now, police found Yell at his home and detained him without incident. He told them he only had an airsoft gun. However, during a search of his home, police found a 9mm handgun that matched the shell casing at the scene of the Walmart shooting. And according to court documents, And this is going to blow your mind. Police also found sports cards inside of his home that were stolen from the burglary, and he admitted to stealing the cards and trading them for drugs. And I know what you're thinking. I can't believe this guy's on drugs, getting in a shootout for Pokemon cards. But alas, he was. The question is, what drugs did homeboy get in return for his Pokemon cards? By the way, if you're a Pokemon card collector, listen closely. Was it crack, meth, molly, or fentanyl? So crack, meth, molly, or fentanyl, apparently you can get those drugs in exchange for Pokemon cards.
I hope it's molly, but what do you guys think?
No way.
You wouldn't give up molly for what drug?
Oh, I would take it, but I just don't think with what he's going, what he's doing to get the money, I think it's bigger than that. Molly is not something that you can do 24 hours a day for four straight days. I mean, you could. It just seems like it'd make you really, really tired. I'm going to go meth. Or crack. I mean,
I can't tell if he's cracked out or methed out. But, I mean, they're both just cheap versions of speed. You know what? I'll go meth just because it's Kennewick.
Okay.
Shout out to Kennewick.
Josh.
Well, I think this way, one of us will win. I'm
going to
stick with Molly.
You're going with Molly. What did you go with, Miles?
I went with meth.
Meth.
Oh, I thought you said crack.
No, I was thinking between the two, meth or crack. Because it just seems like he needs a lot of money to keep buying the drugs. Like, Molly, you do, like, one day, but maybe you don't do it 24 hours straight. You know what I'm saying?
We also have jobs.
Yeah. So.
All right, then I'll take crack, Thrill. Let's get them all in.
You go crack?
I'll go crack.
Okay. All right, Josh, you want to go Molly? Final answer.
Final answer.
We're going to find out what this Pokemon card-stealing man was on. Was it crack, meth, molly, or fentanyl next?
That was a tease.
This Father's Day, refresh Dad's tool collection with the sweetest brands like Kobalt at Lowe's. Right now, you can buy one select Kobalt 24-volt max kit and get one select Kobalt bear tool free, up to a $139 value. The gift of powering Dad's summer projects is priceless. Shop Lowe's in-store or online today to make it happen. While supplies last, valid 5/2 through 7/31.
Everything is better electrified, like the guitar, toothbrushes, or cars. And Hyundai has a wide range of electrified vehicles, including the first ever Tucson and Santa Fe plug-in hybrid EVs. You can use electric when you want it or gas when you need it. It's your journey. Evolve it beyond the pump in the 2022 Tucson or Santa Fe plug-in hybrid EVs. Visit your nearest Hyundai dealer or learn more at HyundaiUSA.com. Only available in select states. Call 562-314-4603 for complete details.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by Chev.
The best defense is a good offense. So before the sewer backs up into your home and wreaks havoc, stop freaking and call Beacon. Beacon Plumbing, Heating, and Mechanical is there for you when you need them most. 1-800-FREAKIN or beaconplumbing.net.
The debauchery rolls on. You're listening to The Men's Room with Miles and Thrill. 99.9 KISW.
Category strong time profile. This guy, a Washington man, was stealing Pokemon cards. Got into a shootout with security. Security did not have a gun. This guy did. Came back trying to get into it with security.
Security did have a gun, yeah.
And he shot him a couple times, right? So question is, he said he was using the money that he sold the cards to buy drugs.
That is correct.
What is the drug? Crack, meth, molly, or fentanyl?
And, Josh, that is the very question that we asked you. So we will start with you, and you said methamphetamine, which makes a whole lot of sense.
I said meth.
Wait, I'm sorry, you said molly.
You
said molly. I'm afraid it was not molly, but, Josh, if it were you and me, that would have been my choice out of the four. Miles and Montgomery, you said methamphetamine.
I did. Okay, I'm right.
That leaves the Ted Smith with the old standard crack.
Ah, oh, no.
Dude was getting fentanyl.
Get out of here.
I should have known that.
You should have known that you can trade Pokemon cards. The thing is, I don't think he
was
selling them.
In Kennewick, Washington, yes.
He was not selling, as the story explains it, he was not selling the cards, taking the money, and buying fentanyl. He was legitimately trading these Pokemon cards for fentanyl. So whoever's dealing the fentanyl is also a massive Pokemon person.
The Tri-Cities, it's a strange place.
That everything about the story. I'm like, wait, you're stealing Pokemon cards and you're getting a shootout? It is not worth getting in a shootout.
Yakima was great for me, though. I had a great time there.
Did you go to the Walmart?
No.
Did you go in the town?
No.
That explains it.
Right. Actually, I did. I went to the Yakima Steakhouse.
Because, Ted, you brought up the Yakima Walmart, and you said it was the worst place ever. And I'm like, I've never been. I don't know. So I think you're having fun. Every single text and email that came in corroborated. Every single one. Not one person said, ma'am, Ted's exaggerating. They're like, no, it's worse than that.
Yeah, Miles, look, I'm not making fun of your lifestyle, but sometimes it's hard to say it's a fun town when all you know is the golf course and a steakhouse.
And a bar.
Right, generally,
which you told me not to walk into, which I agree with you after that. I was like, this is a dangerous place to walk into a bar randomly as a random white guy.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, trust me. I agree with that. You are spot on that one. Now for all TV news all the time, it's time for TV Time with Ted. No kidding.
And now, it's like, because Ted your pathetic life is confined to countless hours in front of a talking box,
I'm again.
The Men's Room presents TV Time with Ted.
Justin, I do this. I got to remind myself sometimes, just because I was in a town to watch college football doesn't make it a fun town. Looking at you, Baton Rouge. All right. First up, you got the
Jimmy Kimmel, Jimmy Fallon.
Seth Meyers.
Seth's on there.
So you know I'm not wrong.
No, I was going to say, bro, you are so right about that.
James Corden.
Oh, wow. Get out of here, James Corden.
Or Ted Smith.
Is it Ted or is it late night?
Right there for you. The title always says I've challenged the teams of writers and help them come up with monologues each and every night. It's up to you to determine, is this an actual late night joke and from whom? Or could it be a The Ted Smith original?
The New York Times published a report detailing a series of coronavirus infections stemming from an anime convention.
Anime?
Anime.
Jesus.
Convention held last month in New York. Well, something tells me they'll be fine with quarantining. Oh, you want me to stay inside for 10 days? Not a problem.
Fallon.
Myers.
The New York Times published a report detailing a series of coronavirus infections stemming from an anime convention held last month in New York. Well, something tells me they'll be fine with quarantining. Oh, you want me to stay inside for 10 days? Not a problem.
What's amazing about that is half the people they've been wearing masks for decades.
Yeah, I know.
You know, like, you would think, you know, like, you're Boba Fett.
Yeah, but it should be one of the safer...
I'm being dead serious.
Over the weekend, Hawaii was hit with a blizzard. That's right. A blizzard in Hawaii. It's basically a push notification from God about climate change.
Kimmel.
Fallon.
Over the weekend, Hawaii was hit with a blizzard. That's right, a blizzard in Hawaii. It's basically a push notification from God about climate change. It's like, hey, wake up.
Everybody knows Joey Chestnut from the hot dog eating contest.
And nowhere else.
He also recently competed in a shrimp cocktail eating contest.
St. Elmo's.
In Indianapolis, where he ate over 17 pounds of shrimp.
God.
I know that he's a competitive eater, but that amount of shrimp still seems a little shellfish.
Ted Smith. Dude, do you think about that 17 pounds? Because typically on the East
Coast,
17. You get half pound or a pound, right?
That's a $17 appetizer. Like, that shouldn't be in an eating competition.
I know, but
hot dogs are cheap.
I could finish a pound probably at the bar, but that's all I could eat, right?
Right, because I'm not eating anything
17
else.
17 pounds.
It's crazy.
That is a lot.
What do you think his poop smells like?
Shellfish.
Shrimp. Yeah.
A man in Italy reportedly wore a fake silicone arm last week to avoid getting a coronavirus vaccine.
They'll never know.
And wait till you hear about how he got out of his vasectomy.
Myers.
No, yeah, Seth Myers.
That is Seth Myers.
A man in Italy reportedly wore a fake silicone arm last week to avoid getting the coronavirus vaccine. And wait till you hear how he got out of his vasectomy.
Vasectomies are big right now.
You know why? Because lockdown just...
I think I do.
Well...
Like, oh, goddamn.
Right. Well, I know the first weekend of March Madness, NCAA tournament. That's generally the two biggest days for vasectomies.
Because people are at home, or they can be. Oh, if they want to be
and
at
there's
home,
stuff on all day.
Yes, exactly.
Right. So it became a thing. I want to... What... I mean, I don't want to say, I know what restaurant I think it is, but I'm pretty sure there's a wing joint that was like, oh, we have a chair for vasectomy dudes.
Didn't we hear about this last year, 2 years ago, man?
Yeah, right.
Like, look, we know this is the time. Right, seriously. We know this is the time. You do it because, you know, you're going to be off your feet for a while, so you're going to watch the tournament. And, yeah, this wing place was like, we understand. No questions. We have a chair for you.
The problem with that is that the person who does that is an intelligent human being. See, you are the person sitting in that chair that's not.
Right.
That's the problem with the whole thing. You know what I mean? Like, you'd rather have the guy that maybe didn't make a good decision.
Yeah, that's a smart man.
Exactly. No one needs to look like you.
Yeah. All right. Let's see. Jonah Hill. Jonah Hill's back in the news. A lot of people are saying he's having his own hot girl summer right now.
Yeah.
He lifts weight. He surfs now. He's got blonde hair and a ponytail. Yeah. He looked super cool, right?
It's not
he's
that factual. I feel bad for him. It's not that, but he's just like, can we please let this go?
Yeah.
Right? Like, I'm just trying to live my life. I'm glad everyone's glad I lost weight, but basically what you're telling me is I looked like absolute S before.
Right, and to his credit, he's always been a super fashionable guy.
Yeah.
He just was a little bigger. So now people are like, oh, he has a fashion sense. It's like, nah, you just...
You can find clothes.
You didn't look like he... You didn't like his looks because you thought they was like... Right, he's always been into clothes, and you're right. Mm-hmm. He can find more stuff that fits that way.
And you know tattoos. What it is? It's like when you wear Victoria's Secret at home. That's all.
I do it every night.
Yeah. So he was on talking about... He's got a new fart machine he likes, and even some of the higher-ups at Netflix. Like, basically, he's in big films, and he's using the fart machine because he likes it, and he's having a good time with it.
This is a really bad old-school fart machine. This is how digital and dumb it sounds, okay? Okay? Like, funny for, like, a six-year-old, maybe, right?
Sure.
I'm going to do press for this movie, Don't Look Up, with all these huge movie stars in it, like Leonardo DiCaprio and Meryl Streep and Jennifer Lawrence and Tyler Perry. And I did the fart machine when someone was talking about climate change. My castmates did not find it funny. Meryl Streep, being the OG legend that she is, did find it funny, which is why I ride for her anytime, day and night.
That's right, Meryl Streep.
So then Adam McKay, the director of this giant fancy film that is amazing, by the way, he says, Jonah, you're going to get a kick out of this. Netflix formally asked me multiple times to ask you formally to stop using the fart machine during press for the film. Like, they don't find it funny and they don't find it interesting. And I just want to say officially, I love you, Netflix. I love working with you. I am a huge fan. I watch your streamer. But no corporate entity will ever silence my digital farts.
It's kind of ironic because I watched a little bit of Superbad last night.
Mm-hmm.
That is a damn funny movie.
It's a very funny movie.
Yeah, like you always see the McLovin, like, memes and stuff. I kind of forgot. I sat there for half an hour. I was laughing my ass off. I was like, man, this is a good movie.
You know, it's funny. You bring up Jonah Hill. I just read something today about Rebel Wilson. And Rebel Wilson, who's lost a ton of weight on her own, right?
Oh, yeah.
70-some pounds.
Yeah, and so, but she's committed to it, man. And I mean, like, she does the exercise, eating right, all this stuff. And part of it, you know, you just want to better yourself. And it's not just weight, just mentally, right? So it's just like, I go through all the stuff, I got the trainer, I'm eating right, I'm starting to really love life, I feel better about myself. Her agents and all the people around her are like, you're making a mistake.
Yeah.
You're the funny fat girl. And she was like, Jesus Christ, man. She's like, even when you try to do good for yourself, people are like, yeah, but they cast you because you're heavy. She's like, okay, well, maybe they won't cast me for that reason,
you know,
I get more parts.
I think because it's real.
Well, it's real, but also those people make money.
I know.
Agent makes money based on his belief of that, right? And that is a role she played. She knew the role she was playing, but she's like, oh my God, as a human being, I'm just trying to better myself, make myself happy.
If Jeff Garland appeared on Curb Your Enthusiasm, he was ripped, he's been working out and jacked, you'd be like,
not funny.
Who is this guy?
Yeah. You know?
Well, yeah, but there's plenty of funny people, and that aren't fat. There's plenty of fat people that aren't funny.
Yeah, but Rebel Wilson's just fat and funny.
But Jeff Garland also gets to do serious roles and stuff. One of the issues Farley ran into was that people wouldn't take him serious as an actor because they just wanted that version.
And Ed O'Neill had that problem.
Right, he's like, I can do this, I can do that.
Ed O'Neill said after he did Married with Children, he was so associated with that character, did a movie called Dutch, I believe it is. And I never saw it, but it's supposed to be somewhat dramatic. But when they had test audiences, he's like, the first scene, he's wearing like a military uniform and he's walking into a courtroom. nothing particularly funny about it, but as soon as he showed up on screen, the crowd started dying.
This Father's Day, refresh Dad's tool collection with the sweetest brands like Kobalt at Lowe's. Right now, you can buy one select Kobalt 24-volt max kit and get one select Kobalt bare tool free, up to a $139 value. The gift of powering Dad's summer projects is priceless. Shop Lowe's in-store or online today to make it happen. While supplies last, valid 5/2 through 7/31.
Everything is better electrified. Like the guitar, toothbrushes, or cars. And Hyundai has a wide range of electrified vehicles, including the first ever Tucson and Santa Fe plug-in hybrid EVs. You can use electric when you want it or gas when you need it. It's your journey. Evolve it beyond the pump in the 2022 Tucson or Santa Fe plug-in hybrid EVs. Visit your nearest Hyundai dealer or learn more at HyundaiUSA.com. Only available in select states. Call 562-314-4603 for complete details.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by CHEV.
When the hot water needs to be hot, when the drain needs to drain, when the toilet needs to flush, you need to do two things. Stop freaking and call Beacon. Beacon Plumbing, Heating, and Mechanical. On call and there when you need them most. 1-800-FREAKIN or beaconplumbing.net.
This Father's Day, refresh Dad's tool collection with the sweetest brands like Kobalt at Lowe's. Right now, you can buy one select Kobalt 24-volt max kit and get one select Kobalt bare tool free, up to a $139 value. The gift of powering Dad's summer projects is priceless. Shop Lowe's in-store or online today to make it happen. While supplies last, valid 5/2 through 7/31.
Take the next step toward the career you want, be it business, cybersecurity, healthcare, or more. UMGC can help you get there. No application fee when you apply by August 31st. Visit umgc.edu, certified to operate by CHEV.
The future will be amazing, and that's all well and good. But what about today? You can feel the rush of a 400-horsepower Nissan Z. Or climb to new heights in the all-terrain Nissan Frontier. Light up the road in the all-electric Nissan Ariya that feels like a sci-fi dream come true. The future will be great, but today is made for thrill. All you have to do is get in a Nissan and drive. 2023 Ariya and Z not yet available for purchase. Expected availability is this spring for 2023 Z and this fall for 2023 Ariya.